Hello there, everybody. Waddles here. Welcome back. Zygum Hosseini. I think I've got the name pronunciation down this time. Probably not, though, but brilliant comment. Put the armor stand right on top of the redstone lamp. Duh. Yeah. Okay. Good idea. And these are the boots, by the way. I'm breaking 3 protection 4. I had it wrong last episode. But last episode, we set up the pumpkin patch over there for October. How spooky. And today, I'd like to just do preparation for the end. I think we're going to fight the dragon next episode. Don't quote me. I'm not entirely sure, but I think we will do that. We'll begin today with a question like I ended yesterday, but a different question this time. Do you want a world tour? Answer that in the comments below if you have any opinions on it. I don't know if I should do a world tour or not. I love to do the tours, but does everybody love the tours? You know what I mean? I don't want to make a tour if there's no interest in it. We could go a little longer without a tour, in my opinion, or we could go with a tour right now. There's a lot of new stuff, but at the same time, like I said, we don't necessarily need one, I think. So let me know what you think about that down in the comments below if you have an opinion. Where I'm going off to right now is the end. I'm trying to find the land route to the end. Wait. Hold on. I just updated my Optifine the other day, right? And the water looks like it's on like the clear water setting to me. I might be imagining things, and it might just be like this now. And I finally updated to 1.12.2 also. But I feel like this water is like clear water. But I just checked the settings and it's not, apparently. So, not sure what's going on there. Don't know if that's a bug that I'm experiencing, but yeah. I would like to establish a land route to the end, like a road somewhere. That's something that I'm gonna probably be doing off camera because it's just doing a road. I have to figure out a design as well for the road, but it would just be nice, I think, to put a road in going from our swamp to the end because it's really not that far. We do have the nether connection to the end, the tunnel going there, but again, I just like to do things on the overworld. It just adds a little bit more detail, and if I ever want to add another area of our world, we have a big long road to do it along. I made it. Finally, I made it. 1,500, 1,000 are the approximate coordinates of the end here. So I want to set up a little base camp here. We're going to make a horse stable, a little pumpkin farm, and maybe a small house. Probably not, though. We're going to throw a bed on the surface here just in case. But pumpkin farm. I'm going to make a pumpkin farm because I may do the pumpkin helmet trick in the end. I'm really not entirely sure if I will use the pumpkin trick in the end, but I'm going to set up a little pumpkin farm just in case because I don't want to travel all the way over here and forget things. I'd like to set up everything that we need over here and eventually even set up a village or some kind of settlement over here. So if we're going to the end, we can come here pretty much empty-handed and have everything that we need here so we can go explore the end, you know, with a pumpkin helmet and with anything else that I would possibly ever need here. Maybe even we set up some kind of potion thing here, which is something that I definitely do want to get into more in this series coming here after we fight the Ender Dragon and all of that stuff. I'd also love to get a beacon sometime soonish, hopefully. So I have a lot of plans for the series. Whoops. Might as well breed them. I didn't know they could take pumpkin seeds, though. That's kind of cool. I guess I might as well make a fence and an enclosure for them. But like I was saying, I have a lot of plans for the series, so it is nowhere near its end. Just so you are aware, just because we're fighting the dragon, the series is not in any way ending. But anyways, I'd like to set up a whole settlement here. So we have the chicken pen now, actually. I'm not sure. Wait, what am I trying to make? I'm not sure what we really need the chicken pen here for, other than, I guess, an egg source. But it's here now. So we need a horse stall and that's actually about all we need here. We just need a horse stall. Stable. Stall. Horse stable complete. Very basic, very temporary stable. But we may or may not leave this here for the existence of the world, or we may completely remove it. But it's just here for now, so when we go to fight the dragon next episode, we can park the horse here. Okay, so for the path that I was talking about, I want to get into that a little bit. And I'm thinking gravel and cobblestone, because this path is going to be very, very, very long. And if I go and pick all these complex materials, I am never going to finish it. I know that's how I am. If I, you know, have to go and gather a bunch of stuff for the thing, I may not even finish it. I won't take it too seriously. So I'm thinking we'll just do a randomized path of cobblestone and gravel. Gravel and cobblestone. And ideally, I'd like to make the path big enough to be visible on a map. Not necessarily the most zoomed out version of a map, but maybe the second most zoomed out version. So we're gonna need a pretty wide path. Something probably looking like this. And then eventually I'd like to line the path with lighting somehow, whether it be pumpkin lighting or torches or something. I'd just like to set up a whole way to travel over here. Now, that's not something we're going to do today, but it's something that I am setting up to be able to work on off camera in between episodes and that type of thing. Just off camera work. The next thing we have to do to prepare for this fight is definitely grab our sword and think about the pickaxe. We definitely are going to need this efficiency 5 pickaxe, because if I have to go into any of the pillars, I'm gonna need to dig fast. So we have both of those. Then I also need to grab the suit of armor, and most importantly, the pearls. We need the pearls so we can open the portal. Now, I believe we only need 12 of these things. And how much blaze powder? Oh, I will need all of my blaze rods. I went to the Nether before this episode and collected some. I wanted to make a brewing stand, but I guess that's out the door. That's all fine, though. And then arrows, check. Extra blocks. That's what we need. We need extra blocks. Now, I was doing a little bit of thinking, and the last time I fought the dragon, I used an unenchanted iron set of armor, and I think I died like 2 times, maybe 3. So I think whatever enchantments we have on our suit will be more than enough at this moment to fight the dragon. I think I should be more than safe. I was thinking perhaps making a brewing stand and making potions, but I don't think that will be necessary. I think this whole set of armor with all of the enchants we have on it will be probably, hopefully, more than enough. I hope. Okay, now I have to get back there. I think I'm set with everything that we need to fight the dragon. This is really exciting, kind of making me a little nervous, but we're definitely set to go back to the Nether thing, or not the Nether thing, the End thing, excuse me, and get ready to fight it. Well, I just had the biggest derp moment of the series so far. I did not forget my pickaxe, it's not that. I just recorded the last clip, the clip of me throwing the pearls into the portal, or placing them in their little holders, and guess what? Then I proceeded to accidentally delete that clip right after I recorded it, so that clip's gone. Trust me, you didn't miss anything, though. I just put the pearls in the portal. However, with all of that, that is today's adventure, today's episode. We will fight the dragon next episode. There's no going back now that this portal is on, and the silverfish are very mad about that, but there's no going back. So I thank you for watching. Like usual, this has been Waddles, and I will see you next time to fight the dragon. Oh boy, let's do this.